The Sikh community have called for this for a long time, a corridor to allow them easy movement between India and Pakistan's Sikh temple, Darbar Sahib, where the founder of Sikhism spent the last years of his life. But its significance goes beyond religion. It's the first visa-free border crossing in the two nations' history.
I see this corridor as a big symbol of friendship and brotherhood. This corridor will make people-to-people contact. After a long time of disconnection, once again, people are connected.
Previously, Sikhs had to travel more than 100 kilometres to visit the pilgrim site, even though the Darbar Sahib is in Kartarpur, just 3 kilometres from the Indian border. The new corridor will connect it with the Indian shrine of Dera Baba Nanak. Pakistan's Prime Minister approved the idea and led the groundbreaking ceremony. Building a road and amenities for the pilgrims is expected to take 4 months.
The reason I want friendship and a strong relationship with India is because the subcontinent is facing the most poverty in the world. If we want to finish or reduce poverty in our region, we need to open our borders for trade.
But the goodwill only went so far. As Pakistan held their ceremony, the Indian Foreign Minister held her own news conference. She dismissed a Pakistani invitation to attend a regional summit as posturing.
We are not responding to it positively because, as I said, that unless and until Pakistan stops terrorist activities in India, there will be no dialogue and we will not participate in SAARC.
India and Pakistan have fought 3 wars since 1947, 2 of them over the Himalayan region of Kashmir, which both claim in full but rule in part. This was the scene in Indian-administered Kashmir on Wednesday after police killed commanders of a Pakistan-based armed group. And yet, just 70 kilometres from the border of the disputed region, building started on a corridor to bind the countries. Sikhism was founded here in the 15th century. As their pilgrimage opens back up, it's hoped Pakistan and India can begin one of their own. Charlotte Bellis, Al Jazeera.